using that massive skull to drive Brian to the mat.
Get him out of the corner. Listen to me. I'm an official.
I'm going
to
tell you right now, for Mark Henry,
come on now.
It's not about winning. It's about hurting his opponent. It's about maiming and putting his opponent out of business.
Oh, remember, Mark Henry was embarrassed by Daniel Bryan last week. Daniel Bryan almost cashed in his Money in the Bank contract on Henry. Just smothers Daniel Bryan. And
oh, no, it's not.
Come on, Mark.
Mark Henry is going to make an example of Daniel Bryan here tonight.
Let's go.
Daniel Bryan deserves it as well. The way he bowed up to Mark Henry earlier on, the stunt he tried to pull last week. Daniel Bryan deserves this.
Now, one could argue that Daniel Bryan was coerced by the Big Show last week, but I understand the point.
No, look at him, look at him, look at him, look at him. He's taking him on. Oh, the world's strongest slam.
That's it.
Career suicide.
Folded in half.
I mean, you know, I guess I got to hand it to Daniel Bryan. He's either A, stupid, or B, he's got some guts.
The guy got a lot of courage, but this is not the way to display courage, man. Going in there and tangling with this monster, come on.
Although, the more I think about it, I think Daniel Bryan's just stupid. Why would you anger this man? Why on earth would you make Mark Henry mad?
Wait a minute.
Oh my, Mark Henry with the steel chair in hand.
And guys, we've seen this play before. We've seen Mark Henry. This is how he's put away so many superstars in the Hall of Pain.
Like I said, it ain't about winning with Mark, man. It's about hurting somebody. This man is losing it here on SmackDown tonight.
He wants to put Daniel Bryan in the Hall of Pain like Josh Sutton. Look at Bryan trying to fight back. And now Daniel Bryan has a chance.
Uh-oh.
That was not smart.
Do it again, D-Bryan. Do it quick.
Yeah, quick. All right.
Bryan got caught.
Thanks for coming. Daniel.
Look out, D-Bryan.
Wow. They're going to be scraping Daniel Bryan off the mat. Hope he's carrying some medical insurance around in that briefcase.
What the hell is wrong with D-Bryan? I mean, you just take your loss.
And another world's strongest slam from the world champion.
Listen, it's one thing to have some guts in a match, but this is pure stupidity. I mean, to attack that man with a steel chair, I understand him, perhaps he's trying to save himself. But here's an idea. Run out of the ring. Get away from the guy. You get what you deserve, Booker, when you egg a guy like Mark Henry on. You know what he's capable of.
Don't do this, Mark. I don't like what I'm seeing right now. Mark Henry's finna put D-Bryan out of business for good. Just like he did Big Show. Just like he did Kane, just like he did Coslaw, put him out of business, totally.
Oh! And here comes the Giant.
Oh, we got a fight.
And Mark Henry, weapon in hand. Come on, Big Show, stick your nose in the business again. Go ahead. Uh-oh.
Oh, no!
Oh, the Big Show! Big Show collapsing the chair with that right hand!
Mark Henry forgot something.
And I think that's where it's going to be after Survivor Series 2. Still around the waist of Mark Henry, the world title.
Hey, Mark! Mark! Hey! You think that's impressive, beating up on somebody half your size? Huh? That impressive to you? Why don't you stay around and watch my match and I'll show you something really impressive.
Well, What a colossal collision course the Big Show and Mark Henry are on when they'll meet for the World Heavyweight Championship in 9 nights at Survivor Series.
Each and every week, this becomes more personal. Big Show's got Mark Henry reeling.
Check this out right here. D. Bryan just took that shot. That was uncalled for.
But that was cowardly by Mark Henry. The shot to the back of Daniel Bryan, and then the look of shock in the face of the world's strongest man as the Big Show with the WMD to a steel chair. We welcome you back to Friday Night SmackDown. This is a, unprecedented 3-on-1 handicap match. The Big Show will face three superstars. The Big Show's also invited Mark Henry to stick around and watch and see what the Big Show's capable of.
Well, Big Show here taking on three men who all of a sudden go right after Big Show. And this is smart strategy here. Trying to break the big man down, and this would be embarrassing for Big Show if he was defeated in this matchup here.
I mean, quickly, these guys look capable of getting the job done. I mean, three big guys, all these guys got to weigh at least by 200.
And they got Big Show down. Show's down.
Quickly, these three gentlemen from Liverpool have taken down the Giant.
And Big Show is was down. Big Show suddenly building momentum, and look at Big Show go against three men.
Big Show just showing how dominant he truly is. Show slams.
I mean, that was with authority right there. Big Show is mad.
And there is the third opponent who is supposed to be in the ring, and I don't think he wants anything to do with Big Show, and can you blame the guy?
And the Big Show in hot pursuit here.
Uh-oh.
The Big Show felt that Mark Henry was sending Show a message by taking out Daniel Bryan.
Oh, man, look at the strength!
Big Show now sending a message to Mark Henry.
I mean, Big Show is in here beating up three men like it's nothing. Wait a minute!
The WMD, the weapon of mass destruction, it's from the Giant.
Message sent. So, Booker, what do you think? Is Mark Henry impressed with this?
Let me tell you something, man. Any way you look at it, that was impressive right there by the Big Show. He's ready.
And the Big Show able to defeat three men here, his opponent for Survivor Series, Mark Henry.
Am I supposed to be impressed? Them guys not me. I'm the World Heavyweight Champion. You see, I know I impressed you. I impressed you last week when I gave you the World's Strongest Slam in the middle of that ring. I impressed you when I sent your big rear end home on vacation for 4 months. And I impressed you and the rest of these nothing people when I won this World Heavyweight Championship. And it's gonna happen again at Survivor Series. And I promise you, what I'm gonna give you is gonna be a lasting impression.
Wow. Strong words from Mark Henry. Strong messages sent tonight.
Well, earlier this week, Miami got the message, WrestleMania is coming to town.
WrestleMania 28 coming here to Miami.
This is the Super Bowl of the WWE, no question about it. WWE fans better get their tickets fast.
This is expected to be one of the biggest events in South Florida.
And I know you want to be there. You got to get in line, though, to get your tickets to the big event.
When I heard WrestleMania was coming to Miami, I was ecstatic. I was calling friends. I was going to WrestleMania.
Woo! Look at all these bunch of people over here. They're going to sell out.
To already be a little hot, but we're really gonna bring the heat.
Oh yeah, we are gonna pack up that Sun Life Stadium.
I know it's gonna be incredibly loud. I know the field's gonna be full of fans. The ring being in the middle of that kind of atmosphere, it'd be insane.
Yes, WrestleMania!
I'm just gonna be so excited the week of WrestleMania, and I'm just gonna be the happiest kid alive. Miami es lo mejor por tener esto aquí y va a ser lo mejor y me voy a divertir mucho.
The one thing I know about WrestleMania tickets is they go really, really fast. And I'm excited, just like the families are that are in line here to buy the tickets.
I'm happy that I'm going to WrestleMania to see The Rock versus John Cena.
The Rock versus John Cena. When I heard it, my jaw dropped.
It's a match that's been anticipated for a very long time. I know all the fans are ready to see this go down.
WrestleMania! WrestleMania! WrestleMania!
And ladies and gentlemen, we're ready for our main event tonight on Friday Night SmackDown in just a bit. Because in 9 nights, they'll captain their teams in a traditional Survivor Series elimination tag match. But tonight they go one-on-one. Will the Barrett Barrage continue versus Randy Orton tonight? Echo Arena here in Liverpool is rocking as SmackDown taking place in Liverpool for the first time ever. It's been a great week for all of us here in WWE.
I saw Booker going round and round and round for hours on that wheel today.
It is Diva action time. It will be Tamina competing here, and she's with her good friend.
Speaking of Divas, look who's with us. Hi, Natty.
Hey, Michael.
How you doing? Natalya's joining us at ringside. I'm so glad to see
you. How you doing?
Up strong, represented.
Booker, I'm doing great.
You're
thank
looking
you.
Good, as always.
Of course.
So why don't you tell her how you really talk about her when she's not sitting next to you?
My opponent, accompanied by Oksana, from Huntsville, Beach,
Michael, what's
Beach,
important
Florida.
Is that you and I get our one-on-one time out here because you actually appreciate a woman who's strong.
Natalya, the experts are saying that you are indeed jealous of Kelly Kelly. Is it true?
Jealous. You know what? Jealous is a strong word, and I am not jealous. And I've been, you know, I'm actually insulted by that, to be honest, Josh.
You know, stop your bias line of questioning. Let a real interviewer do the job here. So, Natalya.
Yeah, Natalya. One thing I've been noticing, Natalya, is your outfits. You're always banging and rocking some nice
Booker.
I see Louis is a good friend of yours, too. Let's
Louis
talk about
Vuitton
that.
Louis Vuitton is pin-up strong. And Michael Cole knows how to appreciate a woman who is strong, bold, bright, beautiful, built in the front, stacked
yes,
in the back.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, and Josh Matthews needs to keep his mouth shut.
Yeah.
Thank you, Josh.
And now Tamina here with a submission maneuver on Alicia Fox.
I hope that Fox doesn't break a nail in this match. That would be a shame.
You often refer to divas like Kelly Kelly, Eve, Alicia Fox as Barbie dolls.
Barbie dolls slash mutts, yes.
Say Fox.
To me, Alicia Fox is far from being a fox. She's more like a muskrat.
Well, Oksana thought she was Rihanna earlier on.
Well, Oksana, you know, not playing with the full deck, but that's a whole other ball game, so we'll leave that one. Yeah, you know, it's actually quite enjoyable to me right now to watch Tamina, you know, put a little bit of pressure on Alicia Fox.
Some people would claim that you're sort of just kind of riding the coattails of the Divas champion, Beth Phoenix. You're kind of cashing
Josh,
in on her success.
Oh, shut up.
That's what I heard.
Beth Phoenix and I are part of a movement, okay? It's called Pin Up Strong. Whoa. It's about being bold, bright, and beautiful. You don't know what you're talking about, so you need to shut up.
I mean, look at Alicia go, though, and Tamina as well.
And Tamina relying on her power here.
Whoa.
That's a girl, Tamina. Oh, poor Foxy.
Alicia Fox, we're going to rely on her athleticism and agility here.
See, Oksana cheering Alicia on.
Let me tell you something. Oh. If I had Oksana in
Tamina
my
down.
Total... Well, wait a minute.
It's one to be over. And Alicia
whoa.
Fox
is
the bell. Rookie with the cat dragged in. You know what?
Here
you know, Michael,
your winner.
Sometimes the best surprises come when you least expect them.
That was a good surprise. I like it.
Well, Natalya, we thank you for joining us here tonight, SmackDown in Liverpool.
Please welcome my guest at this time, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus. How are you?
What's the crack, fella?
Well, listen, lately a lot of people are saying that you have a tendency to be a hothead, and this was proven last week on SmackDown. Just take a look.
Was this justified? Remember, Christian had once again cost Sheamus a victory. It was at the hands of Wade Barrett. Barrett would come from behind and continue the assault here on Sheamus. But answer the question for yourself. Is Sheamus a hothead? Does Sheamus have a quick temper? Or is all this justified?
Beat him. And after seeing that, how do you respond?
Reputation for being a hothead? I don't know what you're talking about, fella, because I'm generally a nice guy. You see, ma, I can go and present an award at the MTV European Music Awards to Justin Bieber, or I can hang out with my cousin Beaker from the Muppets. See, I'm all about having a laugh, a good time, and besides, I don't have a temper.
Well, Seamus, I've seen it. When someone crosses you, you have the tendency to possess a vicious mean streak, don't you?
Let's just say, I'm spirited.
Told you. For this,
now look at this, guys. There is Hunico, and he's been flanked by Primo and Epica.
Let me tell you something, man. Every time I see these guys, they just keep multiplying and multiplying like gremlins. And guess what? They're in action next.
We welcome you back to Friday Night SmackDown. Hunico on the left, Primo in the middle, Epico on the right. And last week, Cole, this group really burst onto the scene and made their intentions known.
Yeah, it was Sin Cara versus the newcomer Epico last week. But we weren't expecting the man who was about to interfere. His name is Hunico, the man who Sin Cara unmasked a number of weeks ago. And Hunico would continue to assault Sin Cara before he would be backed by Epico. And what was shocking here is these two men worked in tandem as they took out Sin Cara with impressive moves like this last week on SmackDown. And now we see as they come to the ring, they've added Primo to the mix. I just want to know what Hunico's doing bringing these other two gentlemen into the fold here on SmackDown.
Fuck you! Oh, fuck you! Stop off! Both of them all in there! Oh, God! It's the mother of all Osmond! Oh, stop me, mother of me, Apple! I know my look, you are Apple, so! Everybody stop a mother, so!
Here we go.
The following tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 479 pounds, Jimmy and Jay, the Usos.
And that was the Siva Tau. The traditional Polynesian battle demonstration does two things. It pumps up the Usos, lets the competition know that it's time for battle.
Just tell it like it is, Josh. It was a war crime. Like, ow, like Bruce Lee, you know, going into action, dog.
Cole, I want to get back to your point about Hunico, Epico, and Primo. One could argue that perhaps Hunico must feel insecure by aligning himself with Epico and Primo.
Well, of course, that's just you thinking out loud there. We don't know that for a fact. What we do know for a fact is this. Epico is actually the cousin of Primo. Been brought into the mix here by Hunico, and we'll see what they, what type of a team they make.
Against here by one of the Usos.
Very well-polished team, and Jimmy and Jay Uso.
Let me tell you something. Epico was on fire last week with Sin Cara. I mean, this guy can actually go out there and get it done. And with the two partners in the corner, I'm telling you, that right there is a crew. These guys are going to watch each other's back.
Tag was made to Hunico there. But I do get the point you're trying to make earlier, Josh. Hunico came in as, well, Sin Cara Negro, sort of stealing the identity of Sin Cara, and hence the reason for the mask versus mask match last month. But look at how aggressive Hunico is here.
And now Epico went off the tag. Quickly into the cover is Epico. Epico and Hunico working as a cohesive unit, and really, you gotta give some credit, Booker, to Hunico for bringing in Epico and Primo, lining these three up.
You know, that's what you gotta do. I mean, if you wanna win, you gotta have a strategy. You gotta have a game plan, and Hunico, I'm gonna tell you, oh, man. I mean, the guy actually knows what he's doing. They're gonna get some work done here on SmackDown.
Another quick cover here on Jimmy Uso.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's see how they do against the Usos tonight, Buck.
Let me tell you something. I like this, man. Like I say, this is a click right here. I mean, these guys are going to watch each other's back, and the Usos better watch out tonight.
So Epico and Primo cousins, Jimmy and Jay Uso, are the twin sons of former WWE Super.